Hi, everybody. This is Susan Elliott, author of Getting Past Your Breakup and Getting Back Out There, for another edition of Relationship Court. Relationship Court is where I, as an experienced therapist, an experienced lawyer, bring you some of the times when legal issues and emotional issues intersect. As I've said in other videos, I will be watching judge shows, and people always want to get their story out. You know, this person was unfair to me, this person did that. And the judge will most likely say, I'm not a therapist. You know, don't bring this stuff to me. I don't want to hear it. I don't even know what to tell you about this. Other judges will listen for a while, but they'll say, maybe you need to see a therapist. And then I'll watch therapy shows, and unfortunately, there are not a lot of female therapists on television, but a lot of times people will go there and they will have legal issues. And they will say, the therapist on television will say, well, I'm not a lawyer, so I can't help you with this. Well, I'm a therapist and a lawyer. So I'm just going to talk to you a little bit about some legal information, some therapeutic information. You know, I'm going to talk about what I tell my clients, and this is not to be construed as legal advice. It's a disclaimer I have to make as an attorney, as a member of the bar. I have to say this is not legal advice. This is legal information based on what I've seen and what the law requires a lot of times, but it's not legal advice. The therapeutic advice does come from, you know, the years that I've had clients and what I would advise any client. One of the things that people do when they go to court is they want the judge to feel sorry for them. They want the judge to really get in there and be sympathetic. Like, I'm a sympathetic plaintiff, and how could you not listen to my story, and how could you not want to help me? There are times in the law where a judge really does want to hear your story, and that's when you have a restraining order. You are going to have to go in there and you are going to have to show that you deserve a restraining order. Now, temporary restraining orders are relatively easy to get, but judges are becoming increasingly irritated by people who go to court looking for restraining orders when they have no business for a restraining order. They're getting a restraining order because somebody else is irritating them. There's no irritation orders. Do not go into court, do not waste the court's time, and do not take time away from a plaintiff who seriously needs a restraining order, somebody who's being abused, a domestic violence victim, because somebody's irritating you. At the same time, don't do that with Child Protective Services. Don't call CPS on somebody because they've irritated you, because they've upset you. Only call Child Protective Services when a child is actually in danger, when a child is actually being abused or neglected. And same thing with animals. It's like, don't call animal control on somebody because they're irritating you. It's like, make sure they're not treating their pet right. They're not restraining their pet. They're not doing what they're supposed to be doing. Don't clog up the court system with your nonsense. If you are being abused, run. Do not walk. Run, do not walk, and get a temporary restraining order. As somebody who's had a temporary restraining order and then a permanent restraining order, I can tell you that the situation is very scary. So if you have a domestic violence number available and the domestic violence hotline is on the internet, please, please, please call an advocate if you're afraid to go to court by yourself. And somebody will go with you. If you go for a temporary restraining order, it's called an ex parte order, which means you don't have to have the other person in court. But when you go for a permanent restraining order, they have the right to show up and refute whatever you have to say. My ex-husband tried to intimidate me into not going for my permanent restraining order. And I have videos on here where his second wife's granddaughter has said that my book is a lie. I will tell you, everything that I documented in my first chapter of Getting Past Your Breakup can be justified by the court documents. I was in court, I stood up and testified as to his abuse, and he was in court, and he did not offer rebuttal. In fact, in the middle of my testimony, his lawyer got up and said, Your Honor, we are not contesting the restraining order. The reason he did that was because he could tell that I was a very credible plaintiff. I was I was detailing exactly the abuse that I went through. It was horrific, it was terrible, and it was fairly recent, and it was fairly regularly. And his lawyer could tell, but he had subpoenaed my mother, he had subpoenaed a bunch of people, and he swaggered into court like who he was. And once I started testifying, his lawyer saw that I was credible, and he said, Your Honor, we're not contesting the restraining order. Even though he subpoenaed people to be his witness, and he was going to bring up all kinds of things, he was going to testify, he did not. I was scared to death. I drove a standard, and when I was coming off the exit that day, my leg was shaking on the clutch. The car was going like this. I was so scared. But I knew I had to stand up, and I had to say, no one has the right to abuse me any longer. And that's exactly what I did. And that's what you need to do. If you're being abused, you need to stand up and say, no one has the right to put their hands on me. I don't care what you did, what you didn't do. No one has the right to put their hands on you. And because I had been beat fairly regularly as a child up until the time I was a late teen, I didn't know that. I didn't know that nobody has the right to put their hands on you. So if you have a legitimate domestic violence, which means one time is enough, nobody has a right to ever put their hands on you. If somebody puts their hands on you once, don't wait for the second time. Go to court immediately, get a temporary restraining order, and then go for a permanent restraining order. And if this does not apply to you, don't clog up the courts with this baloney, because domestic violent victims do not need to be doubted when they go to court. So if you're not a domestic violence victim, don't go into court asking for these hokey restraining orders, because this is crap. But if someone hits you even once or pushes you, puts their hands on you in any way, get a restraining order. And I am going to tell you that document as much as you can, but even if it's only once, no one has the right to put their hands on you. Now, if you go to court and you say, oh, Your Honor, you know, I had to get a restraining order, that's why, you know, they were not allowed back in the apartment, and then I threw out all their stuff because I knew they couldn't come back, no judge is going to buy that. I'm going to talk in another video about disposing of stuff and adding, you know, dividing it all up. But for now, I'm going to tell you that if you think running to court, getting a restraining order, and then disposing of all this stuff is the way to do it, especially if you don't have any grounds for that restraining order, a judge is going to eat you up and spit you out if the judge has any credibility whatsoever. So don't do that. Don't use a restraining order as a weapon. It's a tool for your own protection. Do not use it as a weapon. It is for domestic violence victims, and if you're misusing it, I hope that the judge takes you to task. And if somebody puts their hands on you, I hope you're running, not walking, to the nearest courthouse and getting a restraining order. This is Susan Elliott with another edition of Relationship Court, and I hope that this helps somebody to either not abuse the court system by getting a restraining order they're not entitled to, or using the court system for a restraining order they are entitled to. And remember, if somebody puts a hand on you, get a restraining order. Period. End of story. You can do this. Over and out.